गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द सेवेंथ वीडियो ऑफ ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 4. चैप्टर नेम इज़ क्लाइमेट एंड दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर द स्टूडेंट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9. स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू आर नोइंग, वी आर डिस्कसिंग ओवर हेयर अबाउट द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग द क्लाइमेट. सो हेयर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑस्किलेशन, अबाउट द ओशन करेंट एंड हाउ द ओशन करेंट अफेक्ट्स द क्लाइमेट ऑफ एनी प्लेस. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो, I would like to request from each and every students that you must watch the videos which we all are providing you. Trust me students, these all videos are very much informative for you and you will get lots of help from these videos. You can repeat the videos, you can see wherever you face the doubt, wherever you just face the problem, you can just rewind the video, you can watch it twice or thrice, okay, until you will not understand. So let's start this video. As I said, we are going to discuss about the ocean current, that how ocean current is affecting the climate of any place. So let's see. Distance from the sea, continentality. As the distance from the sea increases, its moderating influence decreases and the people experience extreme weather condition. This condition is known as continentality. Okay, in previous video also we discussed little bit about the continentality. So what does it mean, students? Suppose that when the distance from the sea will just increase, if we talk about the inner part of India, okay, we are knowing that we are living in the northern plain. Okay, so here I'm just drawing the northern plain. We can see over here, if we are living over here in the northern plain, so it is far away from the ocean body or the water body. Okay, it is far away from the ocean and water body. That's why sometime we just receives the summer season, then winter and rainy season also. So rainy season is coming because of the monsoon wind, because of the arrival of the monsoon wind. But generally, the areas which are far away from the ocean or water bodies or big water reserves, so they receives the extreme climate, and that type of climate is only called continentality. See the next slide. When we talk about the factors that affects climate, so in that water bodies plays very important role. Large bodies of water such as lakes and oceans have an important effect on the temperature of an area, because the temperature of the water body influences the temperature of the air above it. Okay, you have read already the sea to land and land to sea bridges, which not allowed the place to just become so hot or so cold. So that is maintaining the moderate temperature of that place. So water body's role is very much important. Next is the atmospheric circulation. What does it mean? Here you will come to know. Yet atmospheric circulation means global winds are another factors that influences climate, because they distribute heat and moisture around earth. Okay, this is saying that from moist area, from the water bodies area, if the wind will just start blowing towards the land areas, so if the land is dry, so that water bodies areas wind will bring the moisture from there and it will start raining and it will just make that dry land into wetland also. So this is the role of the atmospheric circulation. How the atmospheric circulation just takes place, that you know, that hot wind just rise up because of the light weight and cold wind just comes down because of its heavy weight. So that's why wind starts moving, and this circulation affects the climate of any place. Okay, it can convert the dry region into wet region and wet region into dry region. You can see here, students, pressure and winds. Wind, the movement of air from high pressure area to low pressure area. As I told you, that from high pressure, you can see over here that if we talk about the high pressure, so during the daytime the land starts just heat up and water body just cools down. So here L is showing this side, this is the night time. So at night, low pressure area will be the water body and high pressure area will be the land side. Okay, so where, from where to where wind will just blow, from low to high pressure belt. and high to low pressure belt. This is the genuine movement of the wind. When we talk about the pressure gradient, so the difference in air pressure between two places, the greater the pressure gradient, the faster the wind speed. Okay, it is talking about the it is talking about the different types of effect, the evaporation and condensation, or the wind speed depends on the earth rotation, especially the earth rotation it depends on, as well as the generation of the high pressure and the low pressure. So wind can be described by its speed, direction and frequency. In this way only we just describe the wind. This is very much important, students. High pressure over Madagascar, you can see the location of the Madagascar. Okay, the presence of the high pressure area east of Madagascar, the intensity and position of this high pressure area affect the Indian monsoon. You can see from here how the wind is started coming from, this is the high pressure, you can see over here, this here in this area, this is 20 degree down. Okay, this is the 20 degrees south. So from this area, when the high pressure will be just created, and when from this side the current will just start coming to the north direction and affect and just meets with the low pressure belt, so what it just make over there, the intensity and position of this high pressure affects the Indian monsoon. Okay, intensive heating of Tibetan plateau. As a vast landmass, Tibetan plateau gets intensely heated during summer. It results in strong vertical air currents, formation of low pressure over the plateau. Okay, what generally happened over here, students, that as you know that plateau are the highlands. Okay, and when the highland will receives the sun rays, this is already higher in comparison of the lower land. So when this area will just get heated, quickly air will just go and reach to the troposphere, and this motion will be very fast. When this hot wind will just start spreading, just take example, then that when it will just start spreading, again just see, this is our country, this is our country India. Okay, and when we talk about the southern part of our India, when we talk about the southern part of India, so from Tibet to Bay of Bengal, the shift of low pressure to the high pressure will generally cause to the cyclonic activities. So this way it affects the climate, and it also is responsible for the formation of the jet stream. Okay, jet stream you will read later on, which is a narrow belt of air which is of very high speed wind, and it just moves from very higher altitude, approx the stratosphere. The pressure and surface wind, you can see over here, the pressure and wind system of any area depend on the latitude and altitude of the place. It influences the temperature. It influences the temperature and rainfall pattern. Already you have read that our latitude and altitude affect the place, any place, it affects the temperature of any place. And pressure belts also used to shift from high to low. When we talk about the lower latitude, so at that place you will just receive the low pressure belt. But when we talk about the higher latitude or altitude, so from there what comes? The high pressure belt just comes. Just take a look that when we talk about the globe, so here if the latitude, if the earth's equator is getting the direct rays of the sun, so here low pressure will just create, and at the top where the polar region is there, so there you will just receive the high pressure belt. And this happens in the higher altitude and the lower altitude also. If we talk about the elevation of the mountain, so on the top of the mountain high pressure is there, and at the bottom of the mountain low pressure is there. The climate and weather condition in India are governed by the atmospheric condition like pressure and surface wind, upper air circulation, western cyclonic disturbances, and tropical cyclones. India lies in the northeasterly wind region. This wind originates from the subtropical high pressure belt of the northern hemisphere. They blow south, get deflected to the right due to the Coriolis force and move toward equatorial low pressure area. Now understand here one term used over here, Coriolis force. So see what happens. You can see over here how the surface wind just takes place. Okay, and how the pressure belt just created. Take a look what it is telling. You can see this is the subtropical high pressure belt. This is the subtropical high pressure belt. Okay, and then after that subtropical low pressure belt. So this depends on the inclination of the earth. Suppose that if earth at that time is inclined toward, if the northern hemisphere of the earth is inclined towards the sun, so at that time which type of pressure belt will be just created over here? The low pressure belt. Okay, in the temperate region low pressure belt will be created, but when we talk about the southern region then it is the high pressure belt. So understand it with the help of the wind movement. Understand it by the wind movement. Wind chart is very much important for you. How the whole process is taking place, when the wind is rising up in the air, it is deviating in two direction. Okay, one in south and one in north. Okay, after cooling in the atmosphere, it just used to come down, because when wind will just get heat, it will just rise up, and when it will just cools down, it will just sink. So this is the movement of the wind. Okay, it will just go up first, then after that it will deviate. Now here you just focus that why it is deviating into two different direction. So this is about the Coriolis effect, which you will just see next. Coriolis effect. So understand over here that how the movement of the wind takes place. So suppose that this is the earth, and when wind is just rising up, it just used to cool down, and then after that meanwhile it used to deviate also in two different direction, one in the south and one in the north, because of the rotation of the earth and due to the Coriolis effect. So when this wind will just cool down again, it will just come downside, and after just coming downside again it will just heat up and it will just rise up. Okay, so this process just takes place continuously. Next, just see air masses circulate globally. At the equator, temperature are relatively high. We know that land and water masses heat up, and as a result these warm the air over them. Air heated at the equatorial region rises to the top of the atmosphere. More air rising beneath it forces the air masses to spread north and south toward the poles. Check it out over here, students. This is about the Coriolis force. So the rotation of the earth causes all moving object in the northern hemisphere, including air mass, to deflect to the right, and those in the southern hemisphere to move to the left. So understand over here, this Coriolis effect is absent at the equator. Coriolis force prevent a direct simple flow from the equator to the poles. This is also known as Farrell's law. So what is happening again, just see here students, in previous slide I had shown. So suppose that wind is just rising from the equator. So what will happen, because earth is rotating west to east, so west to east this way it will just rotate. Okay, so what will happen when something will just go up air, up in the air, what it is written over here, that earth causes all moving object in the northern hemisphere, including air masses, to deflect to the right, in the southern hemisphere to move to the left. So in northern hemisphere, whatever will just rise up, it will move to the right, it will move to this direction, and whatever is in the southern hemisphere, it will move to the left direction. So this way the air just deviates, and it is applicable on each and everything. Some questions are mentioned over here, students, that draw the diagram of earth and show the movement of wind. Okay, you have to show the movement of wind, this movement, that how from subtropical the air is moving to the tropical, and then after that from tropical to subtropical and the higher altitude. Describe the Coriolis force. Okay, one slide is mentioned about the Coriolis force, that whatever we just toss in the air, it just deviate because of the rotation of the earth. So that is about the Coriolis force. So this is the end of the video, students. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much.